Hi, in this video, let's create this simple text animation effect using HTML and CSS. So here in my HTML file, I have a div with the class of container, and inside this div, I've added another div and I've given it a class of text. And here I've added some text, and that is all we need for the HTML. Now let's add some styles. So I'll go to my CSS file. The first thing I'll do is select the class of container. I'll give it a height of 100 VH. I'll give it a width of 100%. And I'll vertically center the text. So I'll set the display to flex. And I'll align the items to the center. Now, let's add a few styles to the text. So I'll select the class of text. And I'll choose a monospace font. So I'll set the font family to monospace. I'll increase the font size to 7VW. Now the reason why I've used the VW unit is to give a responsiveness to the text. Finally, let's add a cursor to the end of the text. So I'll add a border to the right, which is going to be 4 pixel solid black. And we have our cursor. Now let's create an animation rule. So I'll say keyframes animate text. So at 0%, the width of the text will be 0. At 50%, the width of the text will be 16 characters, which is equal to the character length of our text. And at 100%, the width is again going to be 0. Now let's add this animation to our text. So I'll say animation name, animate text, and I'll set the animation duration to 5 seconds, and I'll set the animation iteration count to infinite. Now if you see in the browser, we are facing some problem with the text. Now this is happening because the words in the text start to wrap and move to the next line as soon as the width of the text starts to decrease. Now to avoid this behavior, we'll be using a property called white space. So let's do that. I'll say white dash space, and I'll set its value to no wrap. And now you can see that the text is on the same line. But now we are facing another issue. To understand this problem, let me add a background color of red. Now what's happening here is the text starts to overflow as soon as the width of the text starts to decrease. So in order to avoid this, we'll be using the overflow property and setting its value to hidden. Now we don't need this background color, so let me remove this. But we still do not have the final typing effect. Now in order to add the typing effect, we'll be adding an animation timing function. So let's do that. I'll say animation timing function. And the value that we are going to use is known as steps. And inside this bracket, we are going to add a number. So in my case, I'll be using 20 as a number. And now we have an effect that looks like typing effect. So as a result, the animation takes 20 steps to move from 0% to 50%. That is from 0 to 16 characters. And again, 20 steps to move from 16 characters to 0 at 100%. And finally, let's horizontally center the text. So I'll go to the class of container and I'll say justify content to the center. But in this case, the cursor is shifting to the left and the text is moving to the right. However, I want the text to be stationary while I only want the cursor to move. So I won't be using the justify content property. Instead, I'll come to the text and I'll give it a margin to the left of 30%. And now our text is stationary while only the cursor is moving. So that is our final effect. And it is quite simple to create a text animation effect using HTML and CSS. So that is it for this video. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, have a nice day.